acting in spite of your fear. People always ask me, what's it feel like to hurl down a chute, an icy chute, at 90 miles an hour? Is it scary? Of course it's scary. I've been lugeing for 20 years and I still experience fear during every single run. The luge is like a water slide on steroids. It's been called the last bit of insanity left in the Olympics. The luge track is a mile-long chute of mean, slick, unforgiving ice that starts 50 stories high. 50 stories! That's way up. It's like this. Imagine laying on a skateboard, holding on to a 60-foot rope, pulled behind a speeding Ferrari, down a mountain, winding mountain road. Yeah, down a mountain pass, snaking left and right, barely holding on. It's nuts. You're on the edge the whole way down. And if you fall off at 90 miles an hour on the asphalt, what do you think? Is it going to hurt? Does anybody have Bactine? Bactine's not going to help, okay? Bactine and Band-Aids will not help. The run down the mountain will take only 50 seconds, but it's going to be the longest 50 seconds of your life. You'll be sliding down that track on a sled, just a 4-foot-long sled. That's not much more than a piece of fiberglass on two steel runners. You know you're going to be reaching neck-breaking speeds of almost 90 miles an hour, pulling up to 6 Gs, and you got no brakes. Does this seem normal so far? The luge is a terrible sport for TV, in that on TV, it doesn't look like we're doing anything. People that watch us on TV think that all we do is hold on and pray. Well, they're almost right. We hold on, we pray, and we steer a lot. We're making hundreds of tiny corrections to have the best line down that track, the best trajectory that'll get us to the finish line in the least amount of time. When you're driving a car on a freeway, small movements on the steering wheel make a big difference. The luge is no different. Tiny movements make a huge difference in the luge. All I have to do is press down with my shoulder, the sled steers right or left. If I turn my head a couple of inches to the left or right, the sled responds. Making a movement as small as a hiccup could cause me to slam into a wall. Once that happens, you're in trouble because you start ping-ponging back and forth, hitting the left and right wall, and there's not much you can do to stop it. When your feet keep slamming into the rock-hard ice walls, it's really easy to fracture bones. If it's your turn to go and you get the hiccups, you better brace yourself because you're going to have a wild ride. Even your breathing makes a difference. We're taught to exhale when we approach the entrance and exit of every curve. Exhaling helps you relax. The more relaxed and loose you are, the faster your reaction time, the faster you go. The top losers in the circuit have been sliding ever since they were 10 years old. 10-year-olds are bulletproof. They don't fear anything. By the time they're old enough to know better, they've developed solid fundamentals. Therefore, they're able to remain totally relaxed down the whole run. They've got no problem breathing calmly the whole way down. When you see some of the top guys lugeing, they look as relaxed as somebody lying on a hammock reading a paperback. With me, it's different. I got started so late that I've never gotten over the fear. After about a third of the way down, the fear from the high speed causes me to forget to breathe, and I become a white-knuckled slider. When I'm lugeing, I don't look like a guy relaxing on a hammock. I look like a cowboy riding a wild bull. Watching the luge on TV is about as exciting as watching grass grow. But live, the luge is unbelievable. You're standing just a couple of feet away from a 20-foot wall of ice, and you hear the eerie sounds, the rumbling, thundering sounds as sleds smash and pummel against the ice. And the crashing gets louder and louder as they near. Suddenly, a blur shoots across the ice and disappears down the track. As they shoot by, you're close enough to them that you can actually feel the wind they make. If it's snowing and the snow is accumulating on the track, as the sleds race by, they seem to leave a puff of white smoke behind them, a wake of snow, like when a car speeds over a road that's covered with fallen leaves. One instant, you see the sled, and then all you see is the snow rolling down the track. It feels unnatural. It feels like if a ghost had just been by. Above and below you, athletes bear down the run, no more than a flash to your eye. They wear a helmet and a racing suit that's so tight that they look like they've been held by the nose and dipped in high-gloss paint. The uniform actually makes them look like human rockets that are painting streaks in the ice as they flash by. You're so close to the action that you can lean over, look a loser in the eye, and feel a rush of wind as they bolt down that run. For an instant, their blazing images become frozen in your mind. studying each racer and coaching every move they make with your eyes, you're swept up in their momentum. At times, you might ask yourself, man, is he going to make it? Is this really a race? Maybe they aren't racing. Maybe they're being sacrificed. As soon as the loser rockets by, your eyes are drawn back up to the mountain where you look for the next victim.